Hi there, it's good to see you today. We did a story for our younger kids earlier, and we'd love to share one for our older kids. So this one's aimed a little more for our kindergarten through fifth graders. But it's a familiar story that I'm sure a lot of you will recognize, with characters that you recognize, and a good thing to talk with your family about. So our story comes from Deuteronomy 31 through 34. Let's begin. Moses was old, and he knew he would not enter the promised land. So Moses gave the Israelites a message before they went into the land of Canaan. Moses told the people he could not lead them into the promised land, but the Lord would get them there. God would go before them and defeat their enemies. Moses explained that Joshua would be their new leader. Moses assured the people that they didn't need to be afraid. God would be with them, and he would not leave them. Then Moses wrote down God's law. He gave it to the priest. He told the priest to read the law to the people every 7 years. This way, the people would listen, remember, and follow the law, and they would teach it to their children. The priest would put the law with the Ark of the Covenant. God told Moses and Joshua to go to the tabernacle. The Lord appeared in a thick cloud and made Joshua the Israelites' new leader. "Be strong and courageous," God said to Joshua. "You will bring the Israelites into the promised land, and I will be with you." God told Moses to write down a song and teach it to the Israelites. This song warned the Israelites that if they disobey God, disaster would come to them. So Moses wrote down the song and read it to the Israelites so that they would remember God's words. Moses said, "These words are your life." Finally, Moses blessed all the tribes of Israel and praised God. "How happy are you, Israel?" Moses said. "Who is like you, a people saved by the Lord? He protects you and fights for you. Your enemies will be afraid, and you will defeat them." Then Moses went to the top of the mountain where he could see the promised land across the Jordan River. Moses died there and was buried. The Israelites wept. Then the people turned to Joshua, their new leader, who would take them into the land God had promised. Wow, there's a lot happening in this story. A lot of sadness, a lot of joy, a lot of all over the place emotions. Could you imagine the people, their leader passing away? But of course, God has a good plan. So this story is from the Old Testament, from the book of Deuteronomy. How does this connect with Jesus? Well, Moses was a good leader for God's people. There was no other prophet in Israel that was like Moses, until Jesus. The Bible says Jesus deserves more glory than Moses. Jesus is our perfect leader. He died and was raised so that Moses and every believer, including you and me, can enter the promised land of God's kingdom. That's a really good news for a really hard time right now. I hope you enjoyed this story, and I hope you and your family can sit and talk about it. We'll see you again soon. Bye-bye.